Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Last time we went over some formulas inside of Excel that we could learn more about in ChatGPT. Today we are going to go over some string functions that you can also learn about in ChatGPT. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So say I'm working with data inside of Excel, and I need to parse this data out. Now right here, I have the first and last name, and there is a simple function up here on the data tab where you can go here and you can make text to columns. But let's say it's not as easily done as text to columns, where I have to actually find out where this space is inside of whatever I have in column A, and I want to put the first half inside of column B and the second half inside of column C. How do I go about doing that? Well, if I come up here, I could try to type something in, maybe how do I split the data in column A? But if I hit go, I'm really not going to find any information on there. So if I cancel out of here and I go to ChatGPT, and I can get to ChatGPT by opening up a browser and going to chat.openai.com/chat. So in ChatGPT, let's try typing this. What string function can I use in Excel to get the data to the left of a space and to the right of a space? And if I hit enter, I can see that ChatGPT is returning the left function to help me to find the data to the left of a string. And then I'm also getting the write function to get all the characters to the right of the string. So what happens if I copy this right here? I'm going to highlight it and then right click and go to copy and alt tab back to Excel. And let's paste this right up here in the formula in B1. And I can see that the first name came across. So I'm going to alt tab back to ChatGPT. And what about the write formula right here? I'm going to highlight that and right click and go to copy. Then alt tab back to Excel. And in cell C1, I'm going to click here in the formula bar and hit paste and hit enter. And I can see that both of these have now been split into their own columns with this function up here. The first one is the left function. The second one is the right function. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. Now, what if I were to put a middle initial in here, Michael A. Scott, and hit enter? I can see that my write function is off a little bit right here. So how can I split that A out and then get the total write function right here? So let's go back to ChatGPT. And I'm just going to go up here and highlight my original question and right click and copy it. And then I'm going to paste it down here. And let's format my question a little bit more. To get the data to the left of the first space and put a comma after that, the data between spaces and the data to the right of the second space. And what happens now if I hit enter? I can now see that ChatGPT is not only giving me the left and the right, but it's also giving me the mid function. So the mid function is going to get my middle initial. So I can see that I was returned with a left, a mid, and a right function. I'm also returned with a note down here that says these formulas assume that there are at least two spaces in the cell. If there are fewer or more spaces, I may need to modify the formula. So that's good to know. But in our case, there is one middle initial with two spaces. So let's copy this one up here. I'm going to highlight it and right click and go to copy and then alt tab back to Excel. And let's delete these first And in B1, I'm going to click here and go up to the formula bar and right click and go to paste and hit enter. So I can see that I am getting Michael. If I alt tab back to ChatGPT, let's next take the mid function. I'm going to highlight all of that. Please note here that I'm highlighting without the little quotations on there because Excel starts every formula with an equal sign. So if I right click and go to copy and alt tab back to Excel, in C1, I'm going to click in the formula bar, right click, and then go to paste and hit enter. And now I can see the middle initial. If I alt tab one more time back to ChatGPT, I can now highlight from the equal sign all the way to right before the last quote. And I can right click and go to copy, alt tab back to Excel. And in my last cell, D1, I'm going to click in the formula bar, right click, and go to paste and hit enter. And now I can see that I've divided my column into three columns right here. So sometimes you can do the text to column split, but sometimes you need a formula to do that. So hopefully this demo showed you how you can ask ChatGPT about string functions inside of Excel and get some really useful information back that you don't have to go hunting down every piece of that function yourself. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. As always, thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.